Hi! It is time to test some ideas for lowering a laser beam's power that my viewers have suggested. We will get far around. I will even test if my favorite stimulant, cola, will work for this. Is this liquid brown sugar the perfect filter for attenuating a laser beam? Let's find out. Use laser safety glasses when handling class 3B and class 4 lasers, and if you're unsure of their true classification. In an earlier video, I lowered a laser beam's power with an ND filter and worn out batteries. I also asked you for other ideas, and a lot of you chimed in. So many, in fact, that I can't test all ideas now, but thank you for all suggestions. Many of you suggested electrical changes, like dialing down the potentiometer on the laser circuit board. That is a proper way of adjusting a laser's power, and for example used in lab lasers with separate power supplies, and easy on some well-built portable lasers like my Hercules and the Dilda lasers. However, on many lasers, there's no access to the circuit board, and you can ruin the laser by dialing the power too high for the laser diode. I will therefore focus on ideas that will work for all lasers by affecting the beam, not the laser itself. Let's start with the idea of using mirrors. This is a beautiful idea working on the fact that no mirrors reflect 100% of incoming light. A typical household mirror with an aluminium coating should reflect around 90% of visible light. Or so my sources say. Let's test this old mirror of mine. First, with the laser at 20 cm distance to the laser power meter. Stabilizes around 145 milliwatts. Now, with a mirror 10 cm from the laser, reflecting back to the laser power meter placed next to the laser, giving a beam distance of 20 cm again. Stabilizes around 127 milliwatts. That's roughly 88% reflection from the mirror, or 1/8 in loss from just one reflection. What if I reflect the beam several times between two parallel mirrors? Not only does it look great, it should lower the beam's power coming out at the other end even more. The beam is reflected three times, as you can tell, with smoke in the air. Here's the result. The laser beam is now reduced to around 88 milliwatts, if I could hold it still. Lower than expected from three reflections. The beam is traveling farther than 20 cm now, but the main culprit is that my household mirrors are not first surface mirrors. The beam has to go through glass before it is reflected by the aluminium. This splits the beam up since the glass is also reflective, and after three mirror reflections, the beam is a row of beams. Not all of it is hitting the laser power meter, giving a lower reading than calculated. This method would work well with first surface mirrors, also known as front surface mirrors. It is also variable by using more mirrors, or more reflections at a steeper angle, but I will need to look for some front surface mirrors. Instead, we can test another suggestion. Use a polarizing filter, since many laser beams are polarized. I do have a cheap polarizing filter. Here you can see how it blocks the polarized reflected light from the table. Nice effect, like you may recognize from polarizing sunglasses. Will it also block the light from a polarized laser? I messed up the filming angle here, but it is a good reminder to watch out for reflections when putting any kind of optics in front of a laser. After placing the camera in a safer place, you should be able to see if the filter lowers the beam power. Yes, works very well. I can dial the power down from 140 to 3 milliwatts. However, you may have spotted an issue. A bright spot appearing on the power head. This flimsy plastic filter does not like to block a 140 plus milliwatts laser. It is getting damaged by the laser beam. I need to upgrade my polarizing filter. And why not go all in and follow this suggestion? use a variable ND filter made up of two polarizing filters. This is a great idea. I bought this one, which should be able to lower the laser's power from 4 to 400 times. And since it is two glass filters, I hope it can handle the power better. Awesome! It is a nice feeling to dial a laser beam's power up and down like this, almost down to zero. The remaining reading on the power meter may simply be the heat radiating from our always warm hands. My only worry is, these variable NDs are so expensive and I'm not sure how much power they can handle. It would be sad to burn holes in this filter with a strong laser. Comments if you would like to see me stress test this filter with stronger lasers anyway, so you don't have to. Alright, can we find a filter that is cheap, variable, will work on all lasers and handle a lot of power? This idea from Nsteam caught my attention. Instead of a lot of food coloring, I could use a dark drink like cola. I just need to remove the bubbles from it, since bubbles will work like tiny lenses and distort the beam. Being lazy and impatient, I will use an ultrasonic cleaner to defist the cola. Cola foam. A round container will have a lens effect, so I will pour the flat cola into a flat-sided box for minimum distortion of the beam. Let me make some more. This is fun. No wonder this makes you burp. After swiping the last bubbles off the inside with a finger, the cola filter is ready for test. Will it attenuate the laser beam? First with the short side. Oh wow, down to 2 milliwatts. I guess the long side is too much then. Yeah, the beam is barely visible on the power head. Cola sure is effective. What if I use a green laser? Okay, the green is completely gone. Only some infrared leakage seems to go through to the power head. Makes me wonder what transmission spectrum cola has. I have put a small amount in a plastic bag and will test what wavelengths pass through it from this halogen lamp. Nice! This experiment confirms that cola mostly lets dark red and infrared pass through. But not much. It is a strong filter. Great for lowering bright laser beams. Calling cola a perfect filter for attenuating laser beams may be a stretch, but on a low budget, I think it is the best idea yet. Finding an optically clear container that doesn't distort the beam is the hardest part. Other than that, the cola filter meets most of my criteria for use in a hobby laser lab. Click like if you like this find as much as I do. Once again, thanks for all the suggestions. I think I need to test the cola filter even further in a future video. Subscribe to unmiss that. Thanks to all my generous patrons. Your help with getting the laser power meter and spectrometer makes videos like this one possible. If you want to help me keep going with the videos too, you can sign up on Patreon. Link in the description. Thank you. Another way of supporting my channel is to watch more of my videos. How about the one where flames react to a magnet? Thanks for watching. Bye for now.